गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? फाइन, ओके, वेरी गुड, मस्ट बी फाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ इज द सेशन ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडीज. एज यूजुअली इट हैपेंस एवरी डे एट दिस टाइम. ऑलरेडी इन द प्रीवियस फ्यू सेशंस, इन ऑनलाइन सेशंस एज वेल एज वीडियो सेशंस, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग. एंड I think, I hope that you may have gone through all those topics and contents in very detail of that very chapter from your textbook, okay? And I also hope that you will do all the related questions, board model questions of that chapter. So, now it is better for us students to start the new chapter after organizing, and that is a staffing. Okay, so today we are going to start the new chapter, next chapter, and that is a staffing. When we say a staffing, then it is the left to right, but in relation to the price level, the aggregate demand curve will be sloping downward from left to right. Okay, students, so in this video session, I have already discussed the meaning and components of aggregate demand, and in online class also, I will go in detail of this topic. Till then, I would like to say thank you very much. Kuhu! When we say a staffing, then it refers to a process of filling up and keeping filled different posts and positions of the organization created through organizing function. Okay. Now, a staffing in fact makes the organization alive. So long as a staffing function is not performed, the organization is simply a skeleton, a structure. And as soon as the competent and eligible personnels are appointed at different posts and positions to execute different jobs, then the organization becomes alive. Thus, from this point of view, you can say a staffing in fact is a process of manning the organization. Okay, that means filling the organization with eligible, competent, talented, experienced and qualified personnels as per requirement of the post and position. In fact, through a staffing, the importance of a post is determined by setting the criteria, by determining the criteria of the personnel to be selected for that post. So, in a staffing function, a coordination has to be made between importance of the post and eligibility of the personnel. There must be a match between eligibility of the personnel and importance of the post, so a staffing in a way is a process of recruiting, selecting, training and developing the eligible and competent personnels to fill up and keeping filled up different posts and positions of the organization with competent personnels. That is all about staffing. Okay. Now let us discuss the importance of staffing. You know, students, already we have seen that staffing is a process of recruitment. What happens in recruitment? First of all, the competent personals are searched out. The competent personals are called to be selected for the organization. And after recruitment, the second step of a staffing process is selection, through which different tests, different interviews are conducted to select the most competent, most eligible person among many. And once a person is selected to fill up a particular post or position of the organization, then the number of training comes, through which the selected person is given training to act, to perform according to requirement of the organization. And after training and placement, the employees, the selected people are developed in different ways, through career orientation, through promotion, and through different things. So a staffing, in fact, is a process that provides the competent manpower, the eligible manpower, the efficient manpower to the organization. So from this point of view, a staffing function of management is very important, and its importance can be explained through some of the highlights, such as, first of all, the staffing function of management helps in discovering the competent personals. Although there may be so many personals to work in the organization, they may have the same qualifications, degrees, but they all may not be equally competent to perform in the organization. Since a staffing involves a thorough examination, a thorough consideration before selection of a person, before appointment of a person, a staffing involves recruitment, selection, training, and development. Thus, we can say that through a staffing process, the management of an organization in fact obtains or discovers the competent personals for the organization. Okay, students, the second one is, the staffing function of management helps in better performance of different departments, of different sections of the organization. In fact, the performance of each wing, each department, each sub-department, each sector, each section of the organization depends on the performance of the personals engaged in them. Thus, from this point of view, a staffing is that strong process through which the competent, eligible, talented, experienced, honest personals are appointed in the organization, which ultimately help in performing better, or which ultimately help in improving overall performance of the organization. Okay, the third important highlight about staffing is that it helps in continuous survival, growth, and expansion of the business. In fact, any organization wants to survive for a longer period of time, and also it wants to explore, expand, and grows in many ways. And in fact, the survival, growth, and expansion and diversification, modernization, etc., all these depend on availability of the company. It is a staffing function through which the competent personals are obtained, they are developed, and they are used for all-round development, all-round progress of the organization. So, through a staffing function, the long-term survival, growth, expansion, and exploration of the business of an enterprise can be ensured. Okay. The next one is optimum utilization of resources. You know, students, the success of management depends on how optimally it utilizes its available resources. So long as manpower, human resource is concerned, it can also be utilized optimally if it is better planned, if it is better selected, if it is better trained, and many more related to manpower requirement of the organization. Okay, so by selecting the competent personals, eligible personals, we ensure the optimum utilization of not only the human resources but of physical resources as well. Why? Because who will use the physical resources? The human resource. And if the human resource is competent enough, then certainly there will be optimum utilization of other physical resources also. So you can say, through a staffing function of management, the organization is benefited with optimum utilization of resources. So long as a staffing function of management is concerned, it is also helpful in motivating the employees in many ways. A staffing does not include only the recruitment and selection, but it also includes training, development, packages. It also includes promotion. It also includes performance appraisal, etc., etc. And through which the competent personals who want to grow their career, in fact, they are motivated, their morale is boosted to do something better. Okay, so from this point of view, the staffing function of management also helps in boosting the morale of employees as well as motivating them towards better performance in the organization. Okay, so students, now in this session, I have already discussed the meaning and importance of a staffing, and the remaining part of this chapter I would like to discuss in coming sessions. Okay, so thank you very much.